obviously, because I'm not Mexican, but I have worked in Mexican restaurants when I used to live in New Mexico, and I worked in, bitch, I will fuck up, better stop fucking quaffing. Anyway, rude. I've worked in a restaurant in New York City, and we used to make guacamole as well, and there's so many variations. So don't leave any fucking flesh on that skin. I be seeing people leaving this shit. Like, are you fucking kidding? That fills up a whole spoon. If I see someone do this shit, I'll fuck you up. Fucking waste of food. Anyway. Start at the end where the stem starts, and you're gonna slice it off. And then, because we're gonna use half, I'm not gonna cut the root, I'm just gonna cut it in half. And we're gonna reserve this other half, and we're going to cut the end. Thank you. the onion, and the sulfuric acid won't produce as quickly, just because if you have a blunt knife, it's putting a lot of pressure onto the onion, causing the sulfuric acid to form. First, you're going to cut horizontal from the onion. So now we will be needing a tomato. This isn't the prettiest looking tomato, and for that I am sorry. It was the ripest one I could find, the one that was the most red. It is the winter time and tomatoes are in season in the summer, so it's not shit work. So I already rinsed it. We're gonna use the same knife and we're gonna cut it in half. And then we're also going to cut this tomato in half. So we're cutting it into quarters. Right? Now what I do is I remove the seed sack. Of the stem and put it to the side. So you just slide it in, remove the seed sack and the core. There's many ways you can use the seed sack. You can make tomato water or a clear tomato soup, or you can just compost it and it might just grow some more tomatoes for you. You never know. I'm gonna be composting this though, because honestly that white mealy part is not desirable in my guacamole, so I'm not using it. So now we're gonna cut it into strips. So we're gonna julienne. Okay. be careful with this shit. Because let me tell you something, all right? There was this one restaurant I worked at, and this guy was chopping up jalapeño, and he was using gloves. But his knife was so sharp, it cut through the glove, so the jalapeño juice seeped into his hands. He went to go use the bathroom. And he had to take the day off. Because he burned his penis with the jalapeño. So, anyway, this is how you cut the jalapeño. You're going to cut the stem. Thank you. this one didn't have that much juice, so I know I'm definitely gonna use the other half. Definitely. This is my guacamole. I hope you enjoyed this video, and let me know if you try your own variations. You guys thought I wasn't gonna let you have the crunch. Well, you were wrong. Bitch.
Hello, mi niños. If you like what you see, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you.